software. So first we'll go for AutoCAD screen, switch off the grid mode and switch on the ortho mode, and command type limits. Go to lower left corner 0, 0, upper right corner 297, 210, and then same, set zoom, enter, all enter. Now we'll go for align command. Select arbitrary point on the lower left corner of your AutoCAD screen and click on the first button of the mouse and drag the mouse in the right side to some distance. Again, you click on the first button of the mouse and you drag the mouse in the upper direction and take some distance and click on first button of the mouse and press enter key. And go to offset, take the distance as 297 and press enter. Select this vertical line and offset to the left side by 297 mm and enter key. Then go to offset, take the distance as 210 and select object to offset. You select this horizontal line and offset to the top side. Then go to zoom extents and then zoom 0.7x and go to fillet between this line and this line. Similarly, fillet between this line and this line. Similarly, fillet between these two lines. Then we go for zoom window. Select, take nearer to the screen and go to D text. Select specify start point. Click on the first button of the mouse. Then take the height as 4, rotation angle as 0. Type the 119th problem. Then go to A, mirror 30 mm by 20 mm, 40 mm is inclined to the wall, is inclined to the wall such that its front view is a square of 30 mm side. The longer side of the mirror, the longer side of the mirror appear perpendicular to both HP and VP. Find the inclination of the mirror with the wall. Then go to zoom previous. Now we go for layer command. Then click on new and type XY and press enter key. And again go to new, type views and press enter key. Then go to layer 0, set the line type of layer 0 as 0.05 and say OK. Set the layer line weight of XY as 0.13 and say OK. And then go to set the layer views of line weight 0.5. Then go to OK. Then close this. Now we go for line command. Draw a line of one horizontal, take any distance and cut, click on the first button of the mouse and then take some distance and click on the horizontal line, and then again you take the vertical direction and then go to offset. So the distance is 40, take the vertical line and offset by 40 mm to the left side, then go to offset, take the distance as 30, you select this line and offset, then go to fillet between these two, and between these two. Then go to line command, draw a horizontal line of some distance and go to line, and draw a horizontal line, go to line, take intersection point of this and perpendicular to this. Similarly, line int of this and take perpendicular to this and go to fillet between this line and this line. Similarly, between these two lines. Then go to select on these 3-4 line and this one and go to CH and go to layer, click on views and switch to the line weight display on. Then you just go to line command, draw a line from here and also draw a line from here, and then you take some distance and go to nearest point on this and draw perpendicular to this. Then go to offset, take the distance as 30 and you select between these two and you select between these two. Then go to break, first point, you take intersection of this and say at the rate. Go to break, first point, select this line at the rate. Then you select by using the crossing window. Then go to layer and make this layer as views. Then go to line, draw a line from intersection part of this and draw a line from intersection part of this and both will go into intersect at these two, and you just go to fill it between these two, and then go to line, draw a horizontal line, vertical line from here, and then go to DDIM. So here go to modify, go to primary units in linear dimension, make it 0, and in the angular dimension you make it as second decimal point. Then go to text, take the align with the dimension line, take the text height as 4 and the vertical centered above, and text offset from the dimension line as 3, and then go to symbols and arrows, take the arrow size as 4, and then go to lines, so take the offset from origin as 3, and say OK and say close. Now we go for the horizontal, select this line, you take this as 40, then dim vertical, select this line and take it as 30, then dim horizontal, select between these two, then you go to text, type square 30, enter, so you just click over this, then go to circle, take intersection point of this and take the radius as 40, then go to break, break this in counterclockwise direction, and this is in the clockwise direction, then go to trim, select between these two and trim it here, then go to line, take intersection point of this and intersection point of this, then go to layer, take this as yours, then go to copy. Now we'll go for group command, group, select objects, you select this, select this, select this and select this, enter, then go to copy, select this entire thing and copy to the next position, and then go to line, draw a line from intersection and draw a line from here, then go to line from here perpendicular to this, and then go to line, take int of this and take perpendicular to this, then go to fillet between these two, then go to trim here, then go to break, break this line first point, take int of this and break first point, take int of this at the rate, go to break, take int of this and at the rate, break first point int of this, say at the rate, then you select all the 4, then go to layer and make this as views layer, then once you get this, then go to break, break this line till here, and you break this line till here, and then dim angular, you select between these two lines, and here it will be 41.41, and go to text, give space, enter, and you place it wherever you want, then go to zoom window, then go to select, select this line and make this line as XY and say escape, then go to empty, mText, select this as a window, and then go to symbol, symbol, switch off the caps lock and type small f5, and then OK, then go to move, select this and place it wherever you want by switching off the ortho. Now we go for the text, select this, put the caps lock on, type X, you type Y, you type VP and you type HP. Again go to dText, here you type caps lock off, A dash, then B dash, then C dash, then D dash. Then here go to A B bracket C and bracket D. And go to move, select of the ortho mode. Go to X, move it, move VP, and here move HP, and here it is A, and here it is B, and here it is C, and here it is D, and now move A dash, then B dash, then C dash, then D dash, then go to copy. Copy this B here, C here, then take A, then take D. Then here you have copy, you have A dash, you have B dash, you have C dash, and you have D dash. Then you have A dash, copy, you have A dash, you have B dash, then C dash, then D dash. Then you come back to A. So here D text, you have B, you have A, you have D, you have C. Then go to move, A, B, C, sorry, B, C. And this is how you will be able to get this drawing. And again, you just dim horizontal, you select this line, you take it and type text, type XQ30 and say place it wherever you want. Then go to move the C dash outside. So this is how you will be able to create the drawing. Then go to answer, type D text, or type answer, then go to zoom window, then go to line, draw the horizontal line by switching on the ortho mode and draw this. Then go to D text, type 41.41, percentage D. Then go to move and place it wherever you want. Switch off the ortho mode, place it wherever you want. Then go to offset, take the distance as 7, select this, and then go to fillet between these two. Then copy, take this, take endpoint of this to endpoint of this, then go to nearest point on this. So then go to move, select this and place it wherever you want. Then go to copy here, take 5 and copy it here. Then go to zoom previous, and this is how you will be able to create the drawing of this. And finally, you're going to save this drawing into the appropriate drive directory and name this file name as P119, and save it. And finally, you